Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the graduate center on the campus of the Mexico Junior College. For tonight's game, please be visiting Lamar Junior College Blue. And your Mexico Junior College Thunderbirds. We now take pride in the play of the national anthem. Just let it roll your back.
sure that we're up and
Returning for your center, number 35, Jared Terry. And Lamar, number 5, Pat Altabuta. On the line, Lee Hubbard.
All right, we are back here at Castor Activity Center trying something different. Maybe that will help, as now I've got it mixed out of the way. Hopefully that XLR is the one we need. And we are plugged in here at New Mexico Junior College, trying to just keep the audio going for the folks there out in Streamland, if you will. here is I'm just going to try a different input right here for the mic. So that's what I'm doing there. Everything else is right. Everything's plugged in. There's your splitter. That's where that was plugged in, which it shouldn't have been. Then let's see. This is us. We're plugged in here. We're plugged in here. Take the splitter out. Test, 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 test. Okay. See if we're getting any audio now. All right, we are back. So now we have audio. Thanks, Coach Rachel Jansen, for that. Appreciate you, man. T-Birds are up 32-11. The problem was we had a splitter plugged in where it shouldn't have been, I think. And now we're good to go. T-Birds are up 32-11 over Lamar Community College. Lamar came in 2-2. T-Birds 2-0. Bear Cherry with 9 points already in this first half for your Thunderbirds. Five more each for Torber and Chaden Stone. So I think we have solved the problem of the audio. Folks here in the gym, the lobby, or out there watching us via the stream, I think we're okay. And now it is the Lopes with the ball. Lamar Community College Lopes coming in. Oh, foul called. It's going to go against number 11, Trey Blackmore. It's the ninth team foul already. 8:42 remains in this first half. First against Blackmore, excuse me. But the T-Birds have used swarming defense and timely offense so far in this one. Good shooting from outside in the first half as well. I'll have to run down and get stats also in between our halftime break, which we'll get. Coach Jordan Burton will be up here as well. And both free throws will fall here for number 12, E.J. Brown. He's 3 of 4 from the stripe now. Has 3 points. It's 32-13 your score. 8:42 remaining in this first half. And a hold up before we put the ball in play after the free throws. And the T-Birds will get it in play. It's Torber with it. He's going to be working against Sean Lindsay here. Back across. Over to Blackmore. Blackmore. Oh, they're going to call an offensive foul on Bear Cherry. He's asking why. I was looking where the ball was, not in the lane, so I couldn't explain it to you. 10th team foul. Second on Bear. So they'll get the ball out of bounds. Will the Lopes here, and they'll inbound. It will be Lee Hubbard with the basketball. Almost losing it there. Good defense by Torber, staying right on him. And having trouble with it, and he'll go back court. Losing his dribble did Lee Hubbard. T-Birds will turn it over again. Look at that defense right there by Leo Torber. T-Birds are playing intense defense this season. Really good to see out here. To 32-13, your score. 8:17 remains here in this first half. Tying his shoe is Torber. Inbounding will be Blackmore. He'll get it over to Chaden Stone. Stone to Torber. Torber now back over to... That was Blackmore inside to Bear Cherry. Two-hand dunk. Jeremiah Cherry with another one. 11 points for him in this first half and a 34-13 lead. There's the shot. It's up. No good. Cherry with the rebound from inside the lane. And the ball will be called out of bounds. Go back over to Lamar as there was a collision near the scorer's table on the far side. So Johnson will check back in for the Lopes here. And the inbound will come back over to the ropes, and of course it's Sean Lindsay with it. Lindsay will pull up, the left-handed shot, short, does not go. Torber with the rebound. Comes right back up the floor, he's to the free throw line, kicks it out. Lindsay into the corner, Johnson with a three. Xavier Johnson now, with that shot, has his first bucket here at home for the T-Birds on the season, making it 37-13. T-Birds cruising against the Lopes here in first half action. 7:05 remains. There's a steal there. Oh, man, Stone got it, but stepped out of bounds before he could save it back in. Cherry and Torber were both there. Would have been an easy bucket for the T-Birds. However, Stone steps on the line. He'll take a seat, get a breather here, as I see Blackmore, Deuce Benjamin in as well for the T-Birds, along with Cherry. Let's see, who else is that? Torber, and that is Johnson. So now a 5-second call, as couldn't get rid of the ball, was Lindsay again. Lamar struggling against these T-Birds here in the first half. 6:52 remains, T-Birds get it back. And they have a 24-point lead at 37-13. Again, we want to congratulate the cross-country teams here. Coach Jeff Becker's done a heck of a job with that squad this year for the T-Birds. They're off to Nationals, which is where our technical help, Mr. Luke McKay, was. And, oh, coming up lame a bit is Torber. Looks like he may have landed hard on that ankle off the foul called. By the way, the foul goes against Jalen O'Brien. It's his first, only the team's fifth. There have been 11 called against the T-Birds already in this first half. But Luke Fay out with the cross-country teams. They were ranked in top three all season long. Win here at home in the regional championships. And now off to Nationals. Good luck to Coach Becker and the cross-country squads. Also, Coach Holly Reyna and the volleyball team being selected for an at-large bid to the national tournament in volleyball with a heck of an effort all season long, not just at that Region 5 tournament, folks, but all season long. And now a big chance. Good defense underneath by number 11, Zach Brown, against Cherry. And Cherry throws one up and gets it to fall. It's a prayer, but it goes. T-Birds up 39-13 now. Lindsay back up the floor for the Lopes, trailing by 26 with 6:20 remaining. Lindsay baseline, kicks it underneath to who other than Bear Cherry. Another turnover, Cherry turns it over, trying to get it over to Johnson, and a bucket on the other side for Lindsay. Lindsay has his first points of the night with that bucket. 39-15 now, T-Birds lead with the basketball coming up. 6 minutes to go in the first half. Torber with a drive, goes all the way around Lindsay. Nobody stops him. He scores easily. 41-15. Leo with five. Now towards the right, or towards his right, he goes. Does number four, Kezia Forrest Lowe. This foul's going to be called on Johnson. That is his second. Johnson has 3 points in this one, and two shots coming here for Lowe. Checking in for the Lopes was Gio Velarde. Velarde out of Denver, Colorado. 6'1 freshman guard. First free throw is up, and it falls for Lowe. His first points on the game. Stovall checks back in, leads the team in scoring for Lamar. Lowe sinks them both to bring the Lopes back to within 24. It's 41-17, T-Birds. 5:45 remaining in the first half. Here comes the T-Birds back up the floor. They'll slow it down just a little bit, as that will be Bailey. Bailey kicks it over to Benjamin. Benjamin back to Johnson, back to Bailey. Johnson just threw that at the feet of number 22, Velarde, freshly in the game. The ball is basically batted around until it falls out of play there. And the T-Birds will get it back. Again, I'm Dusty Windham. Thanks for joining us wherever you are, even if you're out in this lobby here. We're good to go again here at New Mexico Junior College. That's going to be Luca Barre already with a trade. Deuce Benjamin with another one. It's his. Deuce. Now with two trades in the game, 8 points on the evening as the transfer coming in from Las Cruces, making a mark here for the T-Birds. 44-17, a 27-point T-Bird lead. As trying to get around everybody was Forrest Lowy. Could not. Now we're going to have a jump ball. It's going to be tied up here. It will be T-Bird basketball as Lowe loses it. And Luke Bray tied him up along with the defense from number three, Elijah Bailey. Bailey out of Brooklyn. Bray from Australia. Adelaide, South Australia. Now we're going to have a timeout, a media timeout here. T-Birds up big. 4:58 remains in this first half. It's 44-17, New Mexico Junior College. We'll be right back. The sounds of Kanye West coming through here in the gymnasium at Castor Activity Center. We're playing these games on Ron Blackcourt, the legendary coach here from New Mexico Junior College. Now we've got everything rolling, audio, video, you name it, we got it. You know what else we got? We got the T-Birds rolling. 44-17 your score here in the first half over Lamar Community College and the Lopes. Head coach Luke McKay has his team rolling. The defense just amazing and intense. It's night and day from last season's T-Bird squad into this so far in this one. Bray with it off the inbound over to Benjamin. Now back over to Bailey. Bailey to Bray. Bray back to Bailey for three. Count it. T-Bird's on fire from downtown tonight. Five for Elijah Bailey in the game. His first three falling. It's a 30-point game. 47-17 T-Birds. 4:35 remaining in the first half. Another takeaway for New Mexico Junior College. And Bailey will get it again. He'll put it up again. And he drains again. Goodness. That's going to be eight for Elijah Bailey here in his home debut. 50-17 T-Birds. 4:17 remaining. And a pass right through the hands of Stovall. Out of bounds. And a whistle. And an overzealous official telling the bench they have to sit down. You can't be excited for your team, apparently, here. Luca Beret and Bear Cherry still arguing his case over there. Luke McKay with a laugh against the official as well. So as much as I found it ridiculous, everybody else did too. So I don't feel as bad. Bailey now with it. He'll drive instead of pull up. High off the glass. No good. The rebound goes off the hands of number 22, Andre Stinson in the game, the 6'10 freshman out of Buffalo, New York for the T-Birds. That ball falls and is caught out of bounds by the black jerseys, so the T-Birds get it back. So just a word from Luke Fay, the cross-country teams have now landed after their second flight there and are ready for nationals. Happy to hear it and happy to see it. T-Birds have it underneath the bucket. 12 on the shot clock. They inbound. Benjamin barely had time to catch it and go back up. And they'll call a foul against Johnson, I believe, is where it's going to go. It is. That will be three on him, I think. Yeah. Third personal foul against Xavier Johnson here. He pushed on the rebound attempt. The call was made. Two free throws coming on the other side now for number 11, Zach Brown. Brown with 2 points, both coming from the free throw line in this one. As he's ready to shoot his first here, and it's off back iron, no good, a break for the T-Birds. T-Birds lead it 50-17, 3:55 remaining now in this first half, and the home team up big over the Lopes. Back at the line, Zach Brown. He'll sink the second 3-for-4 from the stripe in this game is Brown. And it's now 50-18, 32-point lead for your Thunderbirds. We'll see if we get Jordan Burton over at halftime. He said he wanted to come over. We'll see, as I'm a long way from the stats and the bench this season. There's a turnover on an inside pass going off the hands of Stinson inside for the T-Birds. That was Velarde to lead it off for number four, Lowe. Lowe back to Velarde. He'll fake the pass. He'll put it up. He misses badly off front iron on the three-point attempt. T-Birds grab the rebound. It is Deuce Benjamin. The deuce is loose, but that pass a little too loose. Gives it right back over to number four, Kizia Forrest Lowe. Now they're going to call a foul on Benjamin, compounding the problem. Three shots coming here. The second foul on Benjamin. So Keziah Forrest Lowe will head to the stripe to shoot three here. He's got 2 points, both coming from the stripe earlier in this first half. 50-18, your score, 3:14 remains here in half number one. First free throw, no good for Lowe. So it's Benjamin Bereg, along with Bailey, Ayul, and Stinson in the game for the T-Birds. First two free throws go off back iron here for the young man at the line, Keziah Forrest Lowe. Third shot will drop. 3-for-5 now from the stripe for his 3 points is Mr. Lowe. 50-19 the score, still a 31-point lead. And here we go. Bailey will bring it back out, fakes right, goes left. Underneath to Stinson, he is hacked, then pushed in the back, just shoved by number 24, Jalen O'Brien. That'll be O'Brien's second. And two shots coming here for number 22, Andre Stinson. Again, a 6'10 freshman post player out of New York, Buffalo, New York at that. And he'll head to the stripe. Lamar outmatched in this one. They've been crushed already by two WJCAC opponents on the season. They lost to Clarendon by 18, lost by 12 to Frank Phillips, and now trail by 31 as the first free throw does not fall for Stinson. Second free throw rattles out as well. So 0-for-2 from the stripe goes Stinson on that trip. And Lamar with a chance to cut into the lead once again. All the way down the floor, over the head of number 11, Zach Brown. And out of bounds. Ayul will inbound for these T-Birds. Ayul out of Braybrook, Australia for these Thunderbirds. Benjamin with a jumper from about 16, faded away and it fell. Now we're going to have a foul called here on number 22 for the T-Birds once again, as Andre Stinson's going to get the call, I think. It will be an intentional foul and a flagrant going against Stinson. He actually absolutely mowed over the young man, number 22, I believe, is Gio Velarde. So for Stinson, that'll be his first foul. Velarde sinks the first. He's now on the scoreboard with a point. And he misses the second. 52-20, your score. Things getting a bit chippy. They're very physical inside. And Stovall will check back in again here for the Lopes. And it looks like Coach McKay will send number 24, DJ Jamerson, to the scorer's table. He'll check in after the next stoppage. 2:25 remains in the first half. T-Birds are up by a cool 32. Oh, my goodness. Whistle happy on that one. Stinson's just standing there, and he gets run into by number 20, Jordan Whitaker. They call the foul on him. I disagree with the call, but, hey, I disagree with a lot of things. Whitaker will head to the line for the Lopes. He missed on the floater, but he'll sink the first on the free throw. So Stinson will take a seat, and Jamerson in. The 6'7 freshman from San Antonio, Texas. Both free throws will fall for Whitaker to cut the lead back to just 30. 52-22, T-Birds lead it. And they'll have the ball. 2:15 remains in this first half. Bailey goes around, drives, little double clutch, puts it up. It does not fall, though, and the rebound will go into the hands of O'Brien. Bringing it back up will be Whitaker. He'll work against Bailey. Bailey has been a monster on defense so far in this one, and now a reach is going to get called. I think they're going to call Ayul on this one. Could be Bailey. And it's going to be Ayul. Is that three on him? Yes, it is. So third team foul, or third personal foul. I couldn't tell you how many team fouls there are at this point. Well over 10. T-Birds had 10, 7 minutes into the game. But that's a product of pressing and the defense that they're out there employing. It's very intense, very in your face. Both free throws fall to make it 52-24. And Trey Blackmore will check back in the game for the T-Birds. Ayul out. Blackmore from San Antonio as well, a 6'2 sophomore. Benjamin with a spin. Puts it up top to Blackmore. Could have been called for a travel, was not. As he shuffled the feet, it's Bailey with another drive. It's blocked. And what are we calling here? Going to be a foul called against Lamar. And it will go against O'Brien. That's his second now in the matchup. Seventh team foul, and it will be at the line. DJ Jamerson. Jamerson yet to score in the game. Looking for his first point here for the Thunderbirds tonight, and it's in. Seeks his first. DJ with a second look here. With a minute 36 to go in the first half. 53-24 is your score. Now everybody got into the lane that time. Going to be a lane violation against number 11, Zach Brown, who was a little quick to it off the hesitation from Jamerson there. A lot of smiles on that T-Bird bench right now with a huge lead, 29 points. Can it go back to 30? Front iron, no. Beret, though, steals the rebound away from Lamar. Gets it back over to Jamerson, who'll put it up and in, and it's 31 instead of 30. 55-24. Minute 25 remaining now in the first half. T-Birds all over the Lopes so far. With the basketball was Whitaker. He'll pull back, try to shoot the three. He airballs it. T-Bird gets knocked to the ground. It was Benjamin getting knocked down. He'll come away with the rebound. Now he's going to get fouled by Whitaker. He had already been fouled once. Hit the floor there underneath. No call, but they get it on the reach that time. Do the T-Birds, 18 foul, and that one goes against, again, Whitaker, his first. Benjamin will head to the stripe with 10 points already on the evening. 106 remains in this first half. So Deuce heading to the stripe. His first is up, and it will fall. He'll get a second look. Benjamin 3-for-3 from the stripe. Now with 11 points on the night. 56-24, your score. That one does not fall. There's that jinx's curse, or the announcer's jinx curse, if you will, coming up there. All the way down the floor was Bilal Cisse. Loses the ball, and a good hustle play. Benjamin hits the ground, could not save it in time. There will be 20 on this shot clock. We're going to have a whistle and a talk at the scorer's table here for the official. So it will be 20 seconds on the shot clock here, 55 to go in this first half. T-Birds up by 32, 56-24. That's yet another pass that Stovall could not handle. He's had four go through his hands and out of bounds. He turns and looks at the gentleman passing, but hey, man, you got to catch the ball when it hits you in the hands. Stovall playing a little blame game there, should not have been. It hit him right in the hands. Off his foot and out of bounds for Bailey, so they'll give the ball back. Will the T-Birds with 43 seconds to go in this first half. Stovall, by the way, leads his team in scoring, I believe, with four in this first half. Yep, it's been that bad for Lamar. 56-22, or 24, your score, 32-point lead. Stovall with a big Euro step, does not fall, rebound fought for, knocked out of bounds, out of the hands of Benjamin, last touch by Gio Velarde, and the T-Birds will get it back. No shot clock, 26.6 remaining in the first half. Blackmore to inbound, he'll get it over to Benjamin. Benjamin looks at Coach McKay, and he's got to get it across the timeline at some point, barely does. 16 seconds remain in the first half. T-Birds will play for the last shot, it'll appear. Now with 8 seconds, Benjamin makes his move. He starts to drive, pulls back. Near the top of the key, he tries to break through the defense. He'll get fouled by number 24, Jalen O'Brien, who will pick up his third with 1.7 remaining. Oh, no, they actually called Stovall on that one. Excuse me. Stovall picks up his first, team's ninth, and Benjamin will go to the line. 3 of 4 from said charity stripe in, on the evening. This one is up and it will fall. It's going to be 12 for Benjamin in the game. Looking to make it 13 right here before the half. 57-24 the score. They can push to a 34-point lead and do as Benjamin hits that one as well. They'll inbound the ball. It'll go off the rafters on the long three-quarter court attempt. But at the half, your Thunderbirds with a 34-point lead. It's 58-24 T-Birds at the half over Lamar. We'll be right back. We are back here at Castor Activity Center. The women's volleyball team now being honored with their, at-large bid to this national volleyball tournament coming up next week. They'll play the 15th. That's next Wednesday against the fine folks from Navarro College in the first round. I'm going to go meet Danny Behringer for my stats here as I await Jordan Burton possibly coming across for a halftime interview. Again, it's 58-24, T-Birds at the half. We are back again here at Castor Activity Center. Again, I'm Dusty Windham. Halftime. T-Birds have the lead, 58-24 over Lamar Community College and the Lopes. And joining me now, assistant coach Jordan Burton, getting his exercise in, climbing the stairs to come see me. Coach, good first half for you. And my first real look at the T-Birds this season. Seems like the defense is much improved. Yeah, Mr. Behringer just there. I know the feeling. Either way. So, Jordan, defense intense. You're right in people's faces. A big change from last season's squad.
Yeah, we wanted to make it a point to be a little bit more athletic and be a little bit quicker and long on the perimeter. Our guards really get after people. They've done it all through the season so far through 2 games. So, really pleased with their effort. I mean, this is a team. Lamar beat Garden City earlier this week. Garden City's ready 16 in the country. That's not a bad team. Our guys are really making a point to sit down and guard. We can stop fouling, we'd probably be in a lot better spot, but right now,
my thought is that the defense kind of leads into that fouling as intense as it's been. You're going to see that happen. But the inside play's been good. Bear looks good again. Deuce is loose here tonight as well. 13 points in the first half. What have you seen that you don't like?
Honestly, not a lot. I think the biggest thing are the fouls, man. We got to cut down on the fouls, especially fouls that are not protecting a layup. Right, like, right now, without getting to the basket, that's not a good foul.
Right.
Without because of gambling the reach, not a good foul. The other thing is we have to move the ball a little bit. We had 10 turnovers, that's way too many. Because the team is not really pressuring. A lot of those turnovers are because people trying to do too much. And they just get the ball high. We're not going to get the book. So if we can stop fouling and take care of the ball a little bit, I think I'd be a lot more pleased in the second half.
So I'm sure that's what you're looking for. Anything else you're looking for in that second half?
Continue to play with energy and effort. I think in a game like this, it's easier to become complacent. I think the challenge is to not play the scoreboard and play possessions. If that happens, you know, we'll get better. If not, we'll build a habit of bad habits. That's not what we want to do.
All right, Coach, thanks for coming all the way up here, man. Good to see you again. So T-Birds still lead it 58-24. And now we're going to have a quick preview of the women's basketball season up here with Rachel Jansen. But we will continue right quickly. We'll be loud enough now, Coach. You guys have been already out on the road. Get your home debut tomorrow. A whole brand new look from last season's squad, but so far so good for your Thunderbirds. Let's talk a little bit about the changes made this season. A lot of new players.
Oh, my. We have one returner, Philippa. She's carrying us. She really is. She's a whole nother level this year. But as far as everybody else, I mean, our freshmen, I mean, they're athletic. We play fast. We play up-tempo. We get out and we press people, and we just cause chaos. So we had the first two games on the road. We're really good. Tomorrow night we play at 6. Lamar is a little bit slower-paced team, so we probably will run them pretty good. Saturday will be a lot better game. That's a 1 o'clock. Yeah, guys are before us Saturday. It's kind of weird. But we play at 1 Saturday after the guys, and that'll be a lot better game. Cochise is pretty good. They're athletic. They're scrappy. They play quick. So that's actually a better matchup for us. But I'm proud of them. They, you know, all these freshmen learning this college basketball thing, but they've bought into what we're doing, and they do exactly what we ask. So that's all you can really ask for.
You know, it is a big jump coming from high school to a JUCO program. The level of athleticism in these players is amazing. Now, let's talk about a returner or two that you have.
Okay, so Philippa, last year, you know, she was not confident. She could let me say that too. She wouldn't be mad. You know, she came in and set the first semester because of her knee injury, and then she blew up second semester. So the spring was really good for her. And when I tell you she can score at all three levels now, we've worked on her three-point shot, and she's so quick to attack. I mean, she's just a stud. She's got multiple offers already, obviously, going D1. So she's the one that's our bread and butter right now.
I'll tell you, I thought she was one of the most improved players last season, just from where she started to where she ended up. It's good to see her out here. Now then, from a coaching standpoint, how much work's left to do?
How much what?
Work is left to do for you.
Oh, gosh. We're freshmen. You know, coaches always say there's a lot of mistakes, and there's days we are on a roller coaster. You know, we see great things, and then we dive back down because of mistakes and inconsistency. That's the biggest thing with freshmen, is that they're still learning to play together and play at this speed and this level. It's a lot higher than high school. You know, you add the shot clock, you add the physicality. There's just a lot, but we'll be fine just getting that consistent, because we've got our rotation. Our rotation is set, and everybody has accepted their role. So that's really good to see.
So don't forget tomorrow night,
yes,
women's basketball as well. The men up 34 at the half over Lamar in a rout so far. We hope for the same result tomorrow against Lamar.
Amen.
With the women's team.
Amen.
Assistant Coach Rachel Jansen, thank you so much.
Thank you. See you guys tomorrow. And by the way, today has been a great day for athletics here. We sent off our cross-country teams, men and women, to nationals. Volleyball, just found out, they're going to nationals as a 10 seed, and then our men are kicking tail. So tomorrow night, it's our turn. Let's go.
I don't know a bad time for athletics at New Mexico Junior College. I'm not going to lie. Rachel, thank you. So we'll get to some stats here now as I get the headset back on instead of passing the mic back and forth. As we'll look at Lamar first. The leading scorer in that first half for Lamar was the 4 points from number 10, Curtis Stovall. Stovall with a couple of turnovers and a foul, one rebound as well. Also 4 points, I guess, tied for the lead would be Jordan Whitaker. Whitaker 4 for 4 from the stripe for his points in that first half. Three apiece for
Keziah Forrest Lowe, Zach Brown, and EJ Brown in the first half. Two apiece for Sean Lindsay and Emmanuel Cruz Jr., number two, who make sure I've got that correct on here. I do. And also for number one, 1 point for Velarde in the game for their total of 24. 16 of 21 from the free throw line, as Coach Burton mentioned all those fouls that the T-Birds have committed in that first half. 21 free throws shot by the Lopes in the first half, 76.2%. But you look, they've only made, what, four field goals in the game? 4 field goals in the game. 4 of 18 from the floor. 22% on the night is Lamar so far. They've only grabbed 9 rebounds, 3 of those on the offensive glass. And they've committed 19 first-half turnovers. Not a recipe for success, if you will, for the Lopes so far. Your T-Birds, on the other hand, well, they've grabbed 20 boards, 10 on each side of the glass, 13 assists on how many buckets? 20 buckets. That's huge. T-Birds are 20 of 32 from the floor for 62.5%. They are 9 of 13 from three-point range for almost 70%, 69.2%. 9 of 18 from the stripe for 50% there. Let's see what they've done here as well. Only 10 turnovers. Jordan mentioned he'd like to see that come down. 20 boards, though, like we said. 9 steals in that first half for the T-Birds. Their leading scorer in the first half was Bear Cherry from the starting side, and 13 also for Deuce Benjamin. They each had 13 off the bench for Benjamin. 7 points for Leo Torber, 6 for Chayden Stone, 3 for Xavier Johnson. You had 8 off the bench for Bailey, 3 off the bench for Bure, 3 more off the bench for Jamerson, and 2 also for Ayul. Ayul, glad to see him back here as well. Love his infectious optimism, really. He's always seeming to smile every time I talk to him. Steals, Cherry had 2, 3 for Deuce Benjamin in that first half. Luca Bure with a couple as well. Massey and Torber with 1 each. Assists, it's Luca Bure with 4 of those in the first half off the bench. 3 more from Deuce Benjamin. Jamerson has 1 as well. Rebounds, it's been Cherry with 6 to lead the way. You had 3 from Massey, 1 from Torber, and 2 rebounds from Chayden Stone. Massey's only played 8 minutes in this one after starting, and had a couple of fouls that he picked up early. Had a turnover and a steal in there as well, with 2 assists and 3 rebounds. It's been a lot of fun to watch Twan play. He's, again, one of the most athletic people on the floor, and that's every night, not just tonight. Either way, you're looking at it here. The T-Birds with a huge lead, 58-24, over the Lopes from Lamar Community College. We'll be back in about a minute with second half action right here from New Mexico Junior College. All right, back here at Castor Activity Center for half number two, live from New Mexico Junior College. I'm Dusty Windham. Thanks again for being here with us, folks. T-Birds have looked really good so far. They have a huge lead here at the half of 58-24 as we begin half number two. Lamar College in the Lopes having a little trouble here against your T-Birds. But again, as you heard Coach Burton say, they beat a ranked team, a top 20 ranked team already this season. And the T-Birds off to a really good start. Already 2-0 on the season. As we get back to the action, it's Lamar with the ball first. Whitaker with it, trying to go around Bear Cherry, pulls up and drains the 10-foot jump shot. And that gives Whitaker his first bucket. Excuse me, is that Whitaker? It's O'Brien, excuse me, Jalen O'Brien with the bucket. Now Torber with the basketball gets stood up and throws up a prayer. Should have been a foul call. Lots of contact. Could have been a travel call. Could have been a lot of things. No whistle. Ball back over. Three-point attempt up and good for number 12, B.J. Brown. Brown now with 6 points leads the Lopes in scoring. 58-29 the score. T-Birds up by double. Three-point shot up and in for Chayden Stone. That's his third of the game. 9 points for Stone. Lead all the way back to 32 right there. 61-29 T-Birds as the Lopes come back up the floor. Another steal with the defense. Massey comes away with it. They'll give it back to Twan. He'll put it up. It's good. And the foul against number 11, Zach Brown. In fact, that wasn't a good foul as in the air and pushing was Brown as Massey was up. And he was talked to by the official right afterwards was Brown saying, hey, man, another one of those, it's going to be bad for you. So Massey now giving the T-Birds a 34-point lead with his first bucket on the night. As I said, he picked up two fouls early in the first half. Free throw down for Massey as well. 3 points for Antoine. 64-29, a 35-point lead. T-Bird looking good. The T-Bird D back at it here. Massey guarding against Brown. Brown throws it away through the hands of number 12, E.J. Brown. So Zach Brown, E.J. Brown each on the floor here. I'll try to remember that as we continue to go. I don't know if they're related at all, but they're from two different towns. So E.J. and also Zach Brown. There's a drive by Torber high off the glass right in the face of number 11, Zach Brown, and that one falls. 66-29 the score. T-Birds with a big lead. There's a pass off underneath to Lindsey. Lindsey comes back up. Gives it to Brown. Brown fighting for possession. Gets it back. He'll kick it over to Lindsey. Lindsey goes inside for O'Brien. He'll put it up and they'll call the foul on. I think it's going to go against Stone. It is, and it's his first foul. O'Brien will head to the stripe to shoot two here. And the first one is up and it will fall for Jalen O'Brien. Makes it 66. Should be to 30, correct? So there we go. The scoreboard's going to catch up with us at some point. 66-31 is O'Brien's able to sink both of his free throw attempts there. And it's a 66-31 game. 35-point lead for the T-Birds as they get the ball back. Pass right back over to Torber. Air balls the tray. Got nothing on it. Smiles a bit. And now he'll get ready to play some D. His defense has been intense. It's really frustrated Stovall at times tonight. And that's who he's on again. Stovall will give it back over to Sean Lindsey. Lindsey across the timeline now looking for some rotation from his offense. Big man up top and O'Brien. He'll try to screen Torber. Misses him twice. Lindsey steps back, puts it up with the left hand from three-point range. No good. And it was from NBA three range. Off front iron. T-Birds with it. Shot up four. Chayden Stone does not fall. This time rebound was grabbed by Brown back to Brown. So from Zach to EJ. Now Lindsey in the corner. Going to try to drive. He traveled. Took way too many steps that time and gets called and turns around and looks at the ref like, hey, come on, that was only four. Either way, a turnover back to the T-Birds with a 35-point lead, just under 17 minutes remaining in the ballgame. 66-31, New Mexico Junior College over Lamar. Pass, Torber caught a pass that was actually intended for Xavier Johnson. Johnson now gets it back, puts it in the middle to Twan, out. Again to Stone, the three this time does not fall. It is Stovall with the rebound for Lamar College. Two T-Birds getting ready to check in for head coach Luke McKay. Almost a steal. Stone gambles. And Zach Brown will score. They call a foul. There was absolutely no contact. From my point of view. Not from the official's point of view, obviously. That foul against the T-Birds, the second team foul. Looks like, is that correct? It went against Stone? It did. No. They're going to give it to Xavier Johnson now. They've corrected it. That's four on Johnson. 66-34 as the free throws fall, and T-Birds get it back. 32-point lead here with about 16:07 remaining in the ballgame. Long three put up. No good this time from Elijah Bailey. Hustle play to get the ball back from Xavier Johnson. Tuan had the one-handed dunk attempt. It does not fall for him. Stovall with a chance, and he'll shoot. And they're going to call the foul here on Bailey. Bailey's pleading his case. Guarantee you that's the wrong gentleman to talk to plead your case to. Third team foul first on Bailey. Stovall now heads to the line. The lefty puts it up, and it does not fall. 0 for 1 from the stripe now is Stovall. Now a conversation between a couple of the officials, as one of them is not real sure what he saw a moment ago or what have you. And they'll get it corrected. Second free throw does fall for Stovall to bring his team back to within 31. 66-35, 15:44 to go. T-Birds with the lead and the ball. Quickly putting it up with Stone again. It was Benjamin. He'll miss from three-point range. And the shot from Stovall's up, and it'll drop. Stovall now with 7 on the evening. T-Birds back inside to Massey. Bailey thought about the three, now kicks it out to Benjamin. Benjamin moves, dribbles. Now go inside to Jeremiah Cherry. Bear getting manhandled, turns around, puts it up and in anyways. Lots of contact, no whistle, but Cherry is able to drain it. Now good hand on defense to knock the ball away. And it will be Lindsay to try to inbound it here for the Lopes. They'll get it to Stovall. Quick turn back over to Lindsay. Lindsay guarded by Bailey as he comes across midcourt. Lindsay works towards his right, tries to leave it off, barely gets it over to Brown. Brown now will bounce pass over to O'Brien. And O'Brien has it stolen by Massey. Massey's going to go the length of the floor. One-hand dunk this time. It goes. 70-37. T-Birds lead it by 33. Stovall trying to go up for a shot here. That should have been a jump ball call. It was a tied ball. Did they call a foul or a tie ball? We'll have a media timeout. The call will go against Deuce Benjamin. And it will be his third foul. Coach McKay looking at the official like, what? What? He wants to know what happened there. Doesn't matter. The foul has been called. Third on Benjamin. T-Birds lead it 70-37 over the Lopes. We'll be back. Okay, we are back here again at Castor Activity Center. And I'm Dusty Windham. The T-Birds coming out of this timeout will, the ball will be actually over to the Lopes here. T-Birds being called, Deuce Benjamin for a tough foul call as he had two hands on the basketball and they called a foul instead of a tie ball situation. I think everybody with those early season jitters, including the officials on the floor and your announcer, everybody around here. Again, I'm Dusty Windham. 70-37, your score. T-Birds lead it with 14 and a half to go in the ball game. T-Birds have a huge lead here. So, here we are, Lope basketball. Underneath their bucket, 25 on the shot clock here at Castor Activity Center. The inbound to Stovall, being guarded by Benjamin. He fakes left and pulls up, hits a shot. 70-39 now, Stovall with nine. Could become the first Lope in double figures tonight. Lope's only had four field goals in the first half. They were like 4 of 19 shooting there. Twan back out. A fake on the pass from Stone. They will go back inside to Cherry. The spin move and the bucket. I think Bears got 17 now. Yes, that's correct. 17 points for Cherry. One of the two returners on this year's squad with playing time. Ayul, of course, here last season. Love to see him out on the floor this year. And a whistle 5 minutes after the shot goes up, but it's going to be a call on Benjamin. No, it'll go against Bailey. Only the second on Bailey. Fifth team foul here in this second half. Sean Lindsay will head to the stripe. First shot up, and it will fall for Lindsay. Lindsay now with 3 points on the evening. They will bring in Stefan, the 7-footer from France. Will Lamar in between the free throws. Both of them made, though, by Lindsay, making this just a 31-point game. So, here come the T-Birds up by 31. 13:40 remains in the second half here. That's going to be Stone again. Or Johnson, excuse me, Xavier Johnson, where's zero. There's a block underneath, and Antoine gets wrapped up. They had his arm pulling back. And ball's going to go out of bounds. They're going to give it back over to Lamar. I tell you, I don't understand some of the inside calls, but that's why I'm up here and not wearing a striped shirt. Lamar to inbound. They'll get it in to number two. That's Emmanuel Cruz Jr., the young man from Springfield, Massachusetts. Give it back over to Lindsay. Lindsay trying to work against Bailey here. High dribble there as he tries to go baseline. He'll put it underneath. Good pass as the defense followed the ball, and it is an easy bucket there for Zach Brown. Brown now has 8 for the Lopes. Benjamin over to Bure. Bure back over to Benjamin. Benjamin down low to Cherry. The spin. He goes up. He's hacked like 6 times. No call. He'll get the rebound as Twan tips it back out. Now he goes up and finally gets a call after the 8th contact attempt under the bucket. Coach McKay pleading his case. He's over. He looked at him. I think I read the word. Never mind. I'll leave it alone. That is 4 against Zach Brown now. Only the second team foul in the half out of 17 contact attempts. The whistle finally blows in favor of the T-Birds here in half number 2. As Cherry will head to the line. 17 points for the Bear. Free throw is up and it will fall. 73-43, a 30-point lead for the T-Birds now. Bear will get another look at it. One, two, three times on the floor. The shot leaves his hand, and it's good. 74-43, 19 points for Cherry to lead the way in the ball game. Lindsay trying to get across timeline. Will, near his bench, picks up his dribble, gives it over to Brown. Excuse me, Stovall now. Spin, puts it up. It's blocked by Massey. Coming down with it is Bailey. He's hacked. No call again. Here comes Cherry, and They're going to call a tie ball on that. You got to be kidding me. You have to be kidding me. T-Birds get it back, though. The inbound goes from Bailey to Bear. Stephon will be called for the foul. He hacked him good. Well, I figured, why not? I hadn't been called yet. He will get called for that. Two more shots for Cherry here. Second on Stephon. Third team foul. Cherry heads to the stripe again. And he'll sink it. Coach McKay, you can hear, even as far away from the bench as I am, is he's barking out some orders to his team, getting the positioning quite right. Waiting to check in will be Trey Blackmore. They'll wave him in, but I guess he's coming in maybe for Bear. Cherry misses the second. Rebound is grabbed by Brown. Hands it off to Lindsey. Lindsey racing up the floor for Lamar. Pulls it back near the top of the key. Now will look towards his right. Now try to drive on Bailey. The pass underneath. Cherry with a block. Sticking with it, though, was Emmanuel Cruz. And he'll put it up and in. 75-45, your score, 30-point lead for the Thunderbirds with just less than 12 minutes left to go in the game. Bure underneath to Cherry. He'll back up. Now kick it back out to Bure. Luca to Massey. Massey looking. He splits the defenders, puts up the floater. It's good. Chuan now with seven, all in the second half. 77-45 with 11 and a half to go in this second half. T-Birds with a 32-point lead. Lindsey with a floater with the left hand. T-Birds just not wanting to foul on that particular exchange, it looked like. Benjamin to Bure. T-Birds with the basketball and a big, big lead. Bear tries to go underneath, has it blocked and goes out of bounds. He claps his hand, shakes his head because he knows that one was on him. So Blackmore and Torber back in the game. That's Cherry and who else sat? Was that Deuce? No, he's still out there. So it had to be Bailey. Shot no good there. And Torber gets called for a foul going for a rebound. Lindsey backs under it. Six team fouls now, second on Leo. As EJ Brown will check back in. There's the inbound there. Benjamin's all over Stovall. Stovall's frustrated as all get out. Cruz almost loses the ball as a high dribble. Could have been called for a carry that time. He'll get it back. Now then they give to Lindsey. Lindsey working against Leo. Leo gave him fits in the first half. Looks like he's going to do the same here in half number two. Stovall with it now, working on Benjamin. He'll drive. Shot no good, high off the glass. He wanted a foul. Luca Bure, two-hand dog. And they'll team up for hanging on the rim. So the technical will go against Bure. And even coach isn't mad about that one. It's just a call that happens. I thought it was kind of wishy-washy, but it doesn't matter. The free throw will fall from the young man at the line, Sean Lindsey. Your score, 79-48, 10:32 to go. Now in the ballgame. T-Birds up by 31. It will be the Lopes to inbound. Brown with it. EJ heads towards the top, now gives it off to Lindsey. Lindsey works towards his left. They're looking for Stovall. He's been most of the offense for the Lopes in this game. Lindsey will put one up. It's going to hit the rim twice, bounce off. Now we're going to have a call on either Lindsey or on Cruz. It will go on Lindsey. He drugged Blackmore to the ground as he was falling. So that'll be his first team's fifth, I believe. Fourth, just fourth. Wow. They'll mop up the moisture will the T-Birds here in the lane. As the players had hit the floor. Now even the official laughing with Coach McKay as he's complaining about the tech foul. It's all smiles on that T-Bird bench right now. 31-point lead with under 10 to go. Benjamin goes down low. And falling was DJ Jamerson that time as he lost his footing. Turns it over, goes back over, and EJ Brown will hit the 10-foot jumper to make it a 29-point game. T-Birds up by 29 with the basketball. That is going to be Benjamin to Beret. Underneath, Torber with the left hand, no good. Gets it back, and the foul. You count that one. I think this one may go against Brown. Nope. It goes 21, not 12. And that's Theo Stefan, his third. We have a timeout on the floor. There's 9:29 remaining in this ballgame. T-Birds with a huge lead right now at 81-50. After the bucket, which will result in a free throw as well off the foul coming here. And really, that ball was kept alive by DJ Jamerson on that exchange off the miss from Torber. He'll slap the ball back over. Torber grabs it, goes back up, scores, and gets the foul called against Stefan. That is the seven-footer there from France for Lamar and the Lopes. The T-Birds well on their way to a 3-0 record in their first home action of the season. Again, coming in 2-0. With wins over Trinidad State 102-72 and versus Otero 95-80 on the season. And we'll get to see the Thunderbird women's basketball team in action. And after echoing what Coach Rachel Jansen said earlier, they'll be ready to go tomorrow night against Lamar College as well, the women. Again, I will say congrats to the cross-country teams and head coach Jeff Becker as both of them, men's and women's, on their way to nationals. They had landed just a little bit ago after their second flight. And also to Coach Holly Reyna and this women's volleyball team here at New Mexico Junior College as they now have qualified for that national tournament, earning the number 10 seed in an at-large bid for the first time in school history. So congrats going all the way around. Now basketball season well underway. Both teams undefeated. Looks like the T-Birds will stay that way with 9:29 to go in this second half. They lead it 81-50. Free throw does not fall for Torbor. Cruz with the rebound over to Brown. Brown's going to try to race up the floor, running over to get him. Jamerson. And Brown goes the length of four, cannot hit the bucket. It's grabbed then by number 11, Blackmore. Then losing the ball is going to be Luca Beret. Just barely waiting in time to get that ball to Lindsay was Cruz as they crossed the timeline. 9:05 remains here, 31-point T-Bird lead. Beret with a good defensive hand. Puts it out of bounds. Good D from Luca. Deuce sits down. Ayul back in the game for your Thunderbirds here. And the inbound play being run, they're looking for anyone to go to. They end up getting it to Lindsay. Lindsay with Leo on him. Luca and Lindsay switch. And the ball goes to Stovall. Stovall is having all kinds of trouble. And he'll lose it as Ayul will knock it out of bounds. So Shaden Stone back in the game here for the T-Birds. Stovall gets loose behind him. And Stone fouls. And how many fouls is that on Shake? Just his second? Yeah, that's what I thought. Second. Eighth team foul now. 8:50 remains now in this second half. T-Birds up by 31. Stovall back to the line. That one falls. Cutting the lead back to 30. Stovall now the first Lope in double figures. Second shot coming here. It will fall. 11 points now for Stovall. His team still trails by 29. Velarde comes in for Stovall here for the Lopes. And it will be T-Bird basketball under 9 minutes to play at 8:42. Blackmore picks up his dribble, gets it over to Ayol. Blackmore almost lost it again. They'll get it to Jamerson. He'll miss the jumper. It's poked away. Lindsey comes away with it. And he has it blocked by DJ Jamerson. The rebound goes over to number 22, and that one, I believe, was Stinson. He'll miss it. Number 22, Velarde. Velarde misses again. Can't get anything to fall. Cantaloupes here. It's been a tough night for Lamar Community College. T-Birds will come away with a rebound. 8 minutes left in the game. Spin. And losing the ball is Torberg. He gets it back off the tip pass. Nice hustle. And this one will go off the foot of Stephon and out. T-Birds will get it back on the side here. I think they're going to reset the shot clock. They had reset it to 27 seconds. Had reset it to the full 30. Back to 27. We're down to 17. And the action will begin again. 7:51 remains. Now back to 20. I think because it went off the foot that time. Either way, T-Bird basketball, Blackmore. To Ayul. Ayul thought about the three. Steps up, picks up his dribble, gives it back over to Stone. Stone's got three trays in the game so far. And there's Torber. Nice moving with the left hand off the glass. Puts it up and in and makes it a 31-point lead at 83-52. Now, Blackmore with the hustle. Knocks the inbounds pass away from Emmanuel Cruz. Sean Lindsey will bring the ball now back up to four. Still has it, guarded by Torber. E.J. Brown now taking on Stone. He'll pull up. Jumper good. Nice little move for Brown there. Brown joins Stovall as the only Lopes in double figures now. He has 10. Trey Blackmore. Ayul. Up top to Stone. Now back over to Blackmore for three. It's good. First tray of the game, he's got three. 88-54, pardon me. Long three up by, that one was Velarde. It will fall short. T-Birds will get it back into the corner. Stone, Ayul, three, no off back iron this time. The save and a great one from number 24, DJ Jamerson. Now he'll get it back on the hustle underneath. He'll score it. 90-54, your score. Timeout called by Lamar College. Your T-Birds up by 36. We'll be back in just a few moments. Back here at Castor Activity Center, I'm Dusty Windham. 6:19 remains in this one. Your Thunderbirds in complete control over Lamar Community College. 90-54 to score. The Lopes with the basketball as we get started. With the ball, that is number five, Sal Savusa. Savusa from Washington, Auburn, Washington. Ball knocked out of bounds and will remain with the Lopes. So Bailey will check back in the game as well for the Thunderbirds, and the ball goes right through the hands of Savusa. He'll get it over to Stefan. Cruz with it, trying to work against Ayul. Can't get around him. The link just too much for him there. Shot clock violation. They couldn't even get the shot off. Could the Lopes, as the defense tightened up a little bit, and fantastic defense for the T-Birds. And again, night and day difference in the defense between last season's T-Birds, this season's T-Birds, at least so far, as this is my first chance to catch T-Birds in action this year. Another chance tomorrow. And you guys will have a chance tomorrow, too. That's going to be a travel, I think, underneath. Shuffling his feet was DJ Jamerson. 90-54 remains the score with 5:33 remaining in the game. T-Birds with a huge lead, a big lead for the home team, and what will prove to be a 3-0 score. Throwing it away was E.J. Brown. T-Birds get it back, three put up, this time by Blackmore. He'll go off front iron, and Savusa will get it back after losing it twice. He'll drive, baseline, stops, Ayul all over him. That's going to be a shot put up and in this time, though, for O'Brien. O'Brien now with 6 points. 90-56 the score at the five-minute mark. 5 minutes to go in this one. Pass from Johnson. He'll get it back now from Bailey. He'll drive baseline, try to get it there. Now all the way out to Blackmore. Blackmore with the drive gets tangled up, loses the basketball, and here comes E.J. Brown with it. He'll pass it off, and a miss on the alley-oop attempt there for Cruz. Pulling up, shooting the tray. Johnson gets it to fall. Xavier Johnson with the bucket there. 93-56. Now they'll call Johnson on a foul. And another media timeout here. Looks like it. Yep, that's where we're going. 4:22 remains, 93-56. T-Birds lead. We'll be back. Right back after the timeout here at Castor Activity Center. I'm Dusty Windham. 93-56 is your score here. T-Birds lead it big over at Lamar Community College. By the way, that foul on Xavier Johnson was the fifth for him, so he's checked out of the game. And long buzzer there. As heading to the line will be E.J. Brown. Brown with 10, Stovall with 10 for the Lopes, the only two in double figures here tonight for Lamar Community College. Free throws up, it rattles but drops for E.J. Brown. He'll get another look here. That was the ninth team foul on the T-Birds, by the way. But there's only 4:22 remaining in this one and a huge lead of 36 points here for NMJC. Second one falls, we'll make it a little closer. 35-point lead, 93-58, T-Birds with it. Ayul with the basketball near midcourt. Kicks it back over to Shaden Stone. Pardon me, got a bit dry there. Stone kicks it over. Blackmore for three this time. Off back iron, no. Ayul right there for the putback, never even hit the floor. From the air, he puts it back up and in, and Ayul has scored. Two for him now, 94-58 your score. We're under 4 minutes to play. T-Birds on their way to their 3-0 record. We'll be back in action against Redland tomorrow. That one off the guy wire will come back over to the T-Birds as it's another miss. And checking in the game now will be Stinson again. Andre Stinson picked up a couple of fouls in the first half when he had some action there and is back out on the floor now for Coach Luke McKay. T-Birds up 36. It's 94-58 with the basketball. Shaden Stone gets a pass over to Blackmore, who fakes it into the corner, gives it back over to Stone. Stone underneath. There's Stinson. He loses it, gets it back, puts it up, and a little strong on that one. It'll come back over to E.J. Brown. E.J. Brown will give it up for, again, the young man, Sal Savusa, number five. 3:10 remains in the ballgame. Hopefully we'll have head coach Luke McKay over in between here. There's a shot up. No good this time for O'Brien with the rebound. It was Stinson. Stinson gives it back off. They'll get it way ahead to Ayul, who outraced everybody, and that's going to be a foul on O'Brien. And O'Brien's sitting there, slaps right at him right after the play. Somebody's got to sit him down. Somebody needs to sit him down, get him settled down. No need for that here in this one. Stinson gets slapped again, and now he's right up in his face. Stinson's looking away, trying to avoid any conflict here. Even Coach McKay begging him to chill out. Now it'll be Stinson who pushes off and gets called for the foul. McKay looks at him, just shakes his head like, what are you doing? I just told you, don't touch him. Either way, Stinson gets called for that one. That will be foul number, there's no way that's foul one. They've got it mixed up on the board, I believe. Three, there you go. So Savuso with it now for Lamar, hoping things don't get any chippier here at Castor Activity Center. It's a tough loss for Lamar and a big win for the T-Birds. Savusa pushes off against number three, Elijah Bailey. Three-point shot goes up, nowhere even near close. And number four, that's Keziah Forrest Lowe, almost shoves the T-Bird player into the stands. No call. Again, things are getting a little chippy here, and the refs got to get control of that, especially the Lamar team. It's not smart. Either way, ball back over to number 11, Trey Blackmore, underneath to Luca Barre, and the scoop and score that time. 97-58, your Thunderbirds up by 39. We'll watch the inside play, make sure it stays clean. As it's O'Brien, he'll kick it out. That is going to be number 22, Gio Velarde, missing again from three. T-Birds will get back. Coach wants them to slow it down here. We're under 2 minutes to play, a minute 44 to be exact. T-Birds up by 39. This one's been over since before half. There's the pass from Bailey out to Luca Barre for three in the corner. Does not fall. T-Birds wanting it to fall each time for their teammates. Good bond between these guys so far this season. And really good to see the togetherness of the T-Bird squad on the bench. 120 remains in this one. It will be Savusa with a chance. Falls short. Ayul comes away with the rebound. T-Birds will slowly bring it back up the floor. Across the timeline comes Bailey. To Ayul, back to Bailey. He'll shoot the three. This one falls after it rattles twice. 100-58, the century mark has been reached at Castor Activity Center tonight. 42-point lead for New Mexico Junior College, and now trying to call a play here is Keziah Forrest Lowe. They'll get it back out. The runner there for Velarde does not fall. Back out to Bailey. He'll slow down now. He'll go right at Savusa with the left hand. Put it up, and Bailey now with 13 in the game. T-Birds up 102-58, folks. This one's done. 33 seconds remain, and your T-Birds will go to 3-0 on the season. Lamar falls to 2-3, even with the foul and the bucket there from O'Brien. Good play from Jalen O'Brien there, the youngster from New York. That one goes against Stinson. That's going to be foul number four on Andre Stinson. 102-60 the score after the bucket does fall. And we will have a free throw. O'Brien hits that one, and that'll push him to 9 points on the night. He's had a tough assignment inside against the T-Birds here. Bailey gets it across midcourt. They'll drop it off to Luca Beret. Shot clock is off. T-Birds will try to run the clock out here and go to 3-0 on the season. Interestingly enough, for Lamar Community College, that's 0-3 against the Wackjack this year. WJCAC opponents, they've lost by 18, 12, and now 41 in this one. T-Birds will wave over at their opposition. I don't believe they're going to shake hands here afterwards, as it looks like it won't be that way. Yep. To the bench go the teams, and the T-Birds will head to the locker room. Winners 102-61 here over Lamar Community College. We'll wait a couple minutes, see if Coach Luke McKay wants to come across or not. And we'll take a quick break, and we'll come back with what we can do stats-wise. I'm going to run across. Oh, no, I'm not. Coach is coming. So give me just a moment here. We are going to take the quick break, and we'll get stats in a few. All right, as we await head coach Luke McKay, your final here tonight, NMJC 102, Lamar Community College 61 on the evening. And Luke McKay is headed this way. And we'll get to him here in just a moment. We'll be right back. Give me about 10 seconds. We are back here at Castor Activity Center. Again, I'm Dusty Windham. A big 102-61 win over Lamar, a team that just beat a top 20 team in the last week, folks. T-Birds looking good on D. Head coach Luke McKay joins us now. Coach, been a long time since I've seen you. Thanks for being here.
My pleasure. Appreciate it. Anytime we get to tip it off, lace them up and play, it's fun.
It's more than fun for me, because I tell you what, it was intense tonight. New defense. Your guards really getting after it out there.
Yeah, we really have some really good guys this year. Coach JB really worked hard in the offseason and recruited some very, very talented guys. And that's everybody. That's the guys that start all the way through to the 12th man on the bench. He did a great job of bringing a team together.
I really like the shooting was amazing there, especially from deep. I thought you guys worked the ball inside real well tonight. Defensively, of course, they were smaller than you guys, no doubt. But you know, again, the intensity's there. The hands are there. Looks like you're guarding every shot real well.
Yeah, Lamar's a very good team. As you mentioned earlier, they just knocked off a top 20 team before they came out here to play. So they're a good team. We're very fortunate. We shot 69% from three in the first half, which is just unbelievable. But we got a lot of guys who can really shoot it, which complements our inside presence of Bear Cherry and Antoine Massey. So we feel like we're in a position where we can put the defense in a tough situation, and they have to decide who they want to guard.
Now that moves you to 3-0 on the season with Redlands coming in tomorrow. What do you know about Redlands?
Scrappy team. They're a talented team. They got a couple guys that can really, really score it. So we're going to have to be ready to lock up and defend. And, you know, the toughest thing in college basketball is going from the last game to the next game. We got a day to prepare for them, and what we can't do is sit back and pat ourselves on the back about winning a game here, because we got another one coming up.
Well, Coach, I'm excited about the season. I was before it started. Thanks for joining us again. Thanks for being here.
Appreciate you. Thanks so much.
Yes, sir. We'll let you get back to the team. Again, T-Birds win it by 41, 102-61. He's headed back to speak with his team and his head coach, Luke McKay. T-Birds move to 3-0 on the season. Lamar falls to 2-3. We'll be back tomorrow again with women's and men's basketball, as everybody in action here at Castor Activity Center. We appreciate everything that these coaches do for us. I know I do. And can't wait for tomorrow night's broadcast as the T-Birds will take on Lamar in women's basketball and then New Mexico Junior College against Redlands after that. Folks, we'll be ready for it all again tomorrow. I'm Dusty Windham. Good night.